A very good morning and welcome to everyone. Myself Rohan Pal from Pharmacy College Club. Alert, the sign of danger. Today, we will talk about child malnutrition. Child malnutrition means when the child is not getting proper nutrition. There are 38.9 million children are overweight, 45.4 million are wasted, and 149.2 million are suffering from stunting. This is why I called it a danger. Let's know what is stunting. It refers to a child who is too short for his or her age. Wasting, when the child is too thin for his or her height. Overweight, all of you know, when the child is too heavy for his or her height. In the world, there are lots of children who were suffering from more than one malnutrition. There were 67 countries all over the world facing stunting, but the number has declined by half since 2000. Asia, Europe, and Latin America performed well, but Africa is still gaining number of stunted children. Southern Asia, with 14.1% stunted children under 5, has the highest stunting prevalence, and it also has 25 million children affected by wasting. Overweight is also a major concern for the children, and about 56 countries all over the world suffering from this. Asia and Africa are only countries with increasing number of children with overweight since 2000. Asia and Africa have the majority of malnutrition children. Asia has 53% and Africa has 41% stunted children. In case of wasting, 70% Asians and 27% African children are affected. Asia account for 48% overweight children, while Africans are 27%. It's time to know about India. In Global Hunger Index, India ranked 94th out of 107 countries. According to Lancet study, in 2019, 68% of children was due to malnutrition. NFHS 2020 report says that in India, children of 22 states and UT face high malnutrition. 9,27,606 kids are also identified by WCD in 2020, out of which 43% live in UP and 30% in Bihar. The states with most SAM kids are marked red. According to a report, there are only 44% infants from 0 to 6 months are exclusively breastfed in India. And due to non-availability of breast milk in the initial month, more than 8,20,000 children lost their life annually. States and UT with better and poor performance in initiating breastfeeding in the first hour of birth is here. According to Food and Agriculture Organization, there are 14% people are undernourished in India, while 51.4% women in reproductive age are anemic. In India, 20% children are suffering from wasting, while 34.7% children aged under 5 are stunted. In 2021, IJCM also reported for more than 135 million obese children. The reports are shocking. We need to act and as fast as possible. Poshan Abhiyan, Prime Minister's overarching scheme for holistic nutrition. This Abhiyan was launched by Prime Minister on International Women's Day in 2018 from Chandjanu in Rajasthan for improvement of nutritional outcome for children, pregnant women and lactating mothers. For this noble Abhiyan, Government of India approved 3-year budget of 9,046.17 crore. In February 2021, the Mission Poshan 2.0 was launched by Nirmala Sitharaman to bring together ICDS, Aganwadi services, supplementary nutrition program, Poshan Abhiyan, scheme for adolescent girl and NCS. For this mission, the government has identified 112 aspirational districts for the initial phase. The finance minister has approved an estimate budget of 20,105 crore for this year. Mission Portion 2 aims to transform the nutritional status of children aged 0 to 6 years, adults and girls, pregnant women and lactating mother across India. It also aims to reduce low birth weight by 2% every year, child stunting 25% by 2022, child underweight by 2% every year, and prevalence of anemia among children, women, and adults and girls by 3% every year. Every year, the month of September is celebrated as Poshan Maah since 2018 to improve nutritional outcome for children, adults and girls, pregnant women, and lactating mothers. It includes a month-long activity focused on antenatal care, optimal breastfeeding, anemia, growth monitoring, girls' education, diet, right age of marriage, hygiene and sanitation, and food fortification. The Ministry of WCD has released a series of activities categorized into four themes for the entire month. Theme 1 is plantation activity. Between September 1 to September 7, it aims to boost plantation drive for Poshan Vatika. Theme 2 is Yoga and Ayush for Nutrition. Between September 8 to September 15, the focus would be on 5-minute yoga protocol. Theme 3 is distribution of regional nutrition kit. Between 16 September to 23 September, regional national kit is expected to be distributed among Aganwadi beneficiaries. Theme 4 is identification of SAM children and distribution of nutrition and supplementary food to the SAM children in the last week of month. So what should be given in the feeding? For infant and young children, breastfeeding is an unequaled way of providing ideal food for the healthy growth and development of the infant. Breastfeeding is the best way to satisfy the nutritional and psychological need of the baby. Complementary feeding should be started at 6 months of age. Fruits, milk, curd, dalia, khichdi, pulses, and vegetables should be given. Breastfeeding must be continued up to the age of 2 years or beyond. And feeding should not be stopped during and after illness. Nutrition for pregnant women. A pregnant woman needs an adequate nutritious diet in which pulses, leafy vegetables, jaggery, date, groundnut, seasonal fruit, milk, egg should be included. Ionized salt and plenty of fluid should also be taken. Heavy work should be avoided and adequate rest is important. IFA tablets should be consumed throughout the pregnancy. And immunization with TT given between 5th and 8th month in 2 doses at an interval of 4 weeks is essential. The table describes anemia during pregnancy. This is a table for weight gain during gestation for twins and single child respectively. In this table, you can see the risk of obesity in pregnancy. Nutrition for lactating mother. Lactating mothers require 550 calories extra per day than what she was taking during pregnancy to meet the needs of production of mother's milk for the newborn baby. She should include more of cereals, pulses, green leafy vegetable, seasonal fruit, milk, ghee, panjiri, etc. in her diet. Breastfeeding should be done in relaxed state because any mental tension decreases milk secretion. Lactating mothers should take IFA tablet for first 6 months of lactation. This is recommended daily dietary allowance for pregnant and lactating women. And the avoided fish is also shown. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.